Ah, here we go. I finally get to fight the Japanese. So, 2 matches ago, which I will be uploading, got to fight the Germans for the first time with my LA-7, which went well. This is going to be a different story. The LA-7, one of its biggest, seems from in my experience, one of its biggest strengths is that it can be quite fast, but it retains energy very well and is quite maneuverable at higher speeds. Well, see, the thing about maneuverability is, you know, the Japanese might hold the record for probably the best maneuverability. Just putting that out there, I don't know. I mean, I don't know, because I haven't fought the Japanese very much at this kind of tier, because I haven't flown that much in the past year and a half. So, this is really going to be the first true time I get to try out the Japanese. So we'll see how it goes. I'm going to try and keep my altitude here as best as possible. And then try and, I don't know, zonk down on them. Actually, come to think of it, I think my very first match I ever flew in the LA-7 was against the Japanese, and I got 2 kills. So, hopefully it goes about like that. Yeah, so it was on this map, but that was ages ago. See, the first two times I flew the LA-7, I think I died both times. Yeah, because I ripped my wings off in the first match. And they were... I can't remember what the second one was, but I died both times, I remember. And these were back in May, I think. Sometime just after the victory packs were released. So, you know, not exactly a year and a half, but I haven't flown that much in that span of time. Flown quite a bit, but I've been doing mostly grinding out my ground forces. And in that time, I managed to grind out all the Soviets, Germans, and United States. Now I'm just taking a break from grinding the British because I'm getting sick and tired of fighting the Russians at battle rating 5.0. So I am going to zip back and start grinding out some aviation tech trees for now. So we got a B7A2 out there, which, oh man, I really wish I'd be able to fly that a little more. Did they switch? No, he managed to get there without... That's so odd. God damn it. Bullshit. I've tried flying the B7A2 and other Japanese attackers on this map before, around this battle rating, ages and ages ago, and I want time to be able to destroy artillery, like this B7A2, but every time I reach the battlefield, there's about 10 Russian fighters at my altitude, zipping right for me, before I can even shoot down, or destroy one artillery piece. Why me? Why can I never destroy any shits? And this guy looks like he's gonna have a good chunk of time to take these out, but we've got somebody looks like he's going straight over the artillery there. Could be that Yak-9 down there. Okay, but we are a full fighter team. Let's see what we've got here. We've got LA-7, me, LA-7, LA-7, I-185, M-82, and an M-71, Yak-9P, Yak-9K, Yak-3P, LA-5FN, and another M-82, I-185. So we're doing pretty good on firepower. Oh, what the hell is the B7A2 doing over here? I thought he would have been, like, over there. Yeah, he's going to get jumped by all these fighters. And come on, please, please, be smart. Really. You know, I did say be smart, not go head on with it and smash into him. Or whatever the fuck he did, but he crashed. Oh shit, there goes our LA-7 diving down. Somebody call me. Oh, there is a Ki-43 down there, so you know what? Fine. But, okay, there goes our I-185. I only see 2 down there right now, but that's because I'm in the clouds. And I was kind of hoping that, you know, our Russian team wouldn't be the typical Russian team and everybody just dives on one thing and then the team's all low and it's all like, what the fuck? And then, son of a bitch. And this is on... Oh, this is a European server. I had to move to get a better look at my ping, because in the clouds it's kind of hard to see. You look up, there you go. I can kind of see it. And I'm like dying of hunger. I need to grab something to eat, but I can't waste any time. I'll have to like eat something while I'm flying. It's not the most exciting thing, climbing from point A to point B. Okay, I'm gonna turn in now, because it looks like we've got a lot of shit down there. And an A6M3 is diving in now, and I want to get at least a kill, but... Oh, motherfuck. Okay, that's what I was worried about. We got a Ki-84 and a Ki-61 here. But it looks like this other LA-7 has turned in with me, so I've got some backup. Of course, it wouldn't be a Japanese team at this battle rating without a 190. Oh god, another Ki-84. But those guys are diving, so it's just me and this Ki-84. And I'm going to try and do the shoot and zip away. Try. Now, so far, the two times I've done it, it's in the past two matches, it has gone perfectly. But, you know, it's a major risk to take, especially when going head on to the Ki-84, of which I don't know what battle rating, or of which I don't know what variant it is, but it's probably just the basic Ki-84, which I forgot what its designation is. What are you trying to do? You're not going to be able to climb. Come on. Too far away. Or too, you're too close. What you doing? See, he notices. What are you going to turn away, or what are you going to do? Make up your mind now, because I have to make up my mind quickly. You're going to dive away? Oh shit, he's going after some other ding-dong. Did he not even notice me? I do exist. Shit, then I didn't kill him. Okay, as for maneuvering with a Ki-84, I'm not exactly sure. Let's see here. So far, so good. He's got two LA-7s on him. Okay, now I'm on your tail. I gotta be careful with my ammo. Very low. There you go. He's down. Ki-84 is down. And we've lost all of our fighters, but they are mostly low. Let's do this, LA-7. It's basically just you and me and that Yak-3 over there who seems to be having troubles. Let's go save that guy. We need to make sure we save all of our fighters as best as possible. Let's not dive on these ding-dongs just yet.
Take him down!
It looks like that's what he's doing. It's a good go for that. Ki-61 down there is ground attacking, so let's worry about these guys. Yeah, you got a good lineup. Come on. Do it.
Do it. Do it right now. Kill him.
Okay, I'm going to drop on this guy, although this guy's definitely looping around now on my ass. I chopped off his wing. I'm going to zoom away from that guy. I chopped off the tip of his wing. That doesn't mean he's going to go down. Come on, take down that Ki-61, please. Looping back. Hit him. He suffers damages of his cooling system. That Ki-84 is still here trying to fight, despite losing half of his wing. Shit, what a warrior. What a warrior. Let's put him down. Well, I guess he didn't lose half of his wing. Wow, really? Holy mother of shit, this guy can take some damage. But I've damaged his elevator, and I'm hoping... There he goes. Good stuff. Okay. Ki-61 here. Took down his elevators. He's going in. There he goes. Okay. And I'm low on ammunition. There are still two unaccounted for. And I got 10... fucking cannon rounds left. It's just fucking dandy. Okay, one of the guys that's unaccounted for is the guy that was ground attacking. I've got to head back, man.
Heading to the base.
Too low on ammunition to fight. I mean, if I was to kill something with 10 rounds, yeah, I'd have to be pretty damn lucky to do so. But so far, so good. This LA-7 seems to know what he's doing. Well, I mean, he doesn't have any kills, but he's alive. And it looks like he's going to follow me back, probably cover me. So, I mean, he seems like he knows what he's doing. He's a good pilot. He chose his targets well, and he's not dead. Although, I'm not saying that these guys are bad at all. I mean, they managed to get a few kills, but at least I'm not the only one alive with no rounds left. Because that sucks. When you've got two enemies that are unaccounted for, you don't know where they are, and you're the last person alive with no ammunition to defend yourself with, yeah, that sucks. Not exactly an episode of Dogfights, is it? I can't just survive 6 million rounds until they run out of ammunition. I should probably get a little bit lower here. Now, my landing skills have probably gotten very, very rusty, but we'll see how it goes. I'm going to upload this one, too, because I'm going to upload the other one because it was my first time flying against the Germans and I got 3 kills. This one I'm going to upload because it's my first time flying against the Japanese. Well, of course, over the past little while. So my plan is I'm gonna land, gonna rearm as fast as possible, hopefully. My crew skills on this aren't the best, but they aren't bad at all. And then I'm gonna immediately start climbing towards their airfield and hope that they aren't doing the same. I would actually really, unless this guy's making the landing as well, he might be, but if he has plenty of rounds, I'd actually be wanting him to climb right now, but chances are he's actually gonna land as well. So what would really suck right now is if we both landed and then an enemy plane showed up. It's just easy fucking pickings, because you know how overpowered the anti-aircraft artillery is on base. And whenever you get within 15 kilometers of an enemy airfield, you get one shot. But when there's enemy aircraft over your airfield, they don't die. That's how it works. It's the story of my life. I'm trying to bleed speed here as best as possible. I'm not going to fire up my 10 rounds, you know, just in case. Okay, I don't know, that's not really the best speed. Still going a little bit too fast. Well, no, I am a little more powerful than, you know, 1910. I don't know what I was trying to say, tier 2 aircraft. I am a tier 4. I am a later era plane, and the landing seems to be going very, very smoothly. Is he making a landing as well? Yes, he is. That's definitely got to be a landing approach. I always hit Q sometimes to look through my binoculars, but I'm not in a tank. I wish planes had something like that. Maybe like a periscope, yes. Something that would allow you to look a little further. I would have thought they would, but maybe not. Could be wrong. Okay, landed. 28 seconds to be repaired. I'm not repairing, damn it. I haven't been shot. I didn't damage myself. Why do I got to wait 20 seconds to repair? Oh, mother of fuck, man. I just want to get back in the air. I want to shoot down some Japanese. If I can. Yeah, I love the LA-7. It's very, very fun. Did he kill his engine, or was he running out of fuel? Or did he... he might have shut his engine off. Which is, I see a lot of people do. It's a good way to drop your airspeed a lot faster. But, I don't know. I never do it, just because I'm stupid and don't do it. Let's take off as fast as possible here. I remember on this specific map, this was ages ago, I'm not sure how long ago, and I don't know if I was squatted with anybody, but I remember we had to land, there was two of us left, we had to land, and there where our airfield got jumped by the remaining enemies, and one of them was a Japanese 190, which is just the fan-fucking-tastic thing to be jumped by. You know, something that dives on you, misses, and then zooms away, and you have no way of catching up with it. Oh, he's respawned as well, so that's good. But yeah, I think there was like 3 enemy aircraft, and I think we lost, but I managed to take down 2 of them. I can't remember exactly. This was ages ago. Ages ago. I don't even remember what I was flying. I think I was flying some sort of yak. Yak to yak. Don't talk back. Unless you want to. I'm trying to look. Ever since I got this monitor a few years ago, I still haven't cleaned it, so that these specs are still on my screen. So I can't see shit. I don't see anything, man. That's why I move it very slightly. Otherwise, I see all this. So any dots that move with the screen. I gotta remember that they could be above me as well. Okay, come on. I'm hoping that they're back there at their airfield trying to rearm and shit and not way up there in the sky. I'm sure this other LA-7 is thinking the same thing. Hoping the same thing. I gotta keep watching because I know how weird that this game can be sometimes. I'm hoping like one of them will start ground attacking, you know? And there's 2 of them. One of them hasn't done shit. Like, he hasn't even seen anybody, because he's got 0 points. I don't know what the hell that guy's doing, or what he is, but as long as he ain't climbing, I'm fine. Or, In other words, as long as he's... If he's climbing, it's hopefully he's not a good pilot. Shit. Okay, well, what do we got here? Who's this guy? This guy is a threat. A major threat. What about this guy? He's actually quite a bit of a threat, too, even though he hasn't spotted anybody yet. Or done anything. So I'm trying to watch here. I'm going to turn my volume up just a little more. Because... So now my volume's up big time in my ear hole, so I might not be able to hear myself talk properly. But it's good to do that because of the new sounds that they added a few patches back, where you can hear aircraft a lot more realistically. So I should be able to react a little faster. Now that's that LA-7's engine that I hear. Hello?
Hello?
It's me. I don't see anything, man. Don't see it. I don't want to see anything, though, but if I see something, it better be below me. See, this is why I could use those binoculars. But that wouldn't make sense, because you wouldn't be able to look down. Ugh, jeez. I mean, I shouldn't be looking down anyways, but it's third person, so fuck it. Now pay attention to arrows on the edges of the screen, red arrows. Those blinking ones up at the top are for ground vehicles, but sometimes, often, they will actually pop up for enemy units. Ground forces, you know, when you can't see them, they'll pop up, and sometimes they'll do the same exact thing here. And this allows you... They're very small on this monitor screen, but it allows you to spot the enemy... Before, now I don't see anything on their airfield, which is unsettling. They're not going to try and wait us out, are they? We've got the same amount of tickets. The game ends in 42 minutes. You got to be very patient to wait out 42 minutes. I'm going to keep climbing though, because I don't trust our chances here right now. Especially when one of them has been uncalled for the entire match. He could be anywhere. I mean, there's nothing on that airfield, I don't think. He's zooming right in. I swear to God, if he gets shot down by AAA, I'm gonna piss on myself. Ugh, where the hell are these assholes? Hello? Is anybody here? Can you come out and die, please? Zero things on the airfield. Great. Oh, wait. Well, there's one above the airfield. KI-61. I have no idea about the flight characteristics of the KI-61. I know that they are quite maneuverable, but I have no idea what KI-61 this guy is. Now, this is the guy that was ground attacking, so it's not the uncalled-for pilot. Please don't die, LA-7. Like, you know, break off. Good, okay. Alright, now is that KI-61? He is going to maneuver with that, which is going to allow me to slip in on his ass. I don't know why he decided to do that. Maybe he thinks he's got the... I don't know, he might have the upper hand on the LA-7. For all things that I know, and I don't know. Yeah, now see, the thing is that this is taking us right down. Oh, actually, no, that guy is pulling up into me. That gave the LA-7 a chance to pop up. He's down. Okay, well, we're going a little too fast here. Just watch our tail. Watch our tail. Make sure our speed doesn't go too high there. Oh, good. For now, I have ripped my wings in the LA-7 before, my first time ever flying the thing, but as for recently, the matches I've played, I haven't ripped my wings, so I don't wanna risk it. Okay, now let's loop this thing back up over this way. I'm just dropping all my airspeed, but... Okay, so that's one of the pilots down, but he's not even the most dangerous one. Actually, yeah, he is. He was the most dangerous one. This guy, unaccounted for, no freaking idea where he is. For all I know, I could just start ground attacking and go back, rearm, ground attack, go back, rearm. He could be anywhere. So I'm going to split up from our LA-7 here and hope that we don't get jumped from above. Because if we do, we can't cover each other. Okay, well, I'm looking down here. I don't see shit. So far, so good, though. 4 kills. I'm very, very happy with that. Been very happy with how the plane controls. See, the thing is the real LA was very, very hard to control. It was very, very, stiff. Not very easy to control for the pilots. In the game, though, it is very, very stable. So when I'm pulling my maneuvers, I don't have any nose rocking, or I don't compress like I would in some other aircraft, which is very odd because that's exactly what the LA did and why it was very difficult for pilots, even though it was a very deadly aircraft in the right hands. But here in the game, it doesn't seem to be affected by any of that. It's very maneuverable for an LA, of course. It retains energy so freaking well. It's fast, but it's not the fastest. Most things are probably going to be able to outrun you, but it is fast. It's nowhere near slow. It's got good roll. Its guns are good if you're okay at conserving ammunition, which I'm sure a lot of you aren't, but if you can learn how to conserve your ammunition a little better than probably me, then you'll be able to use the guns just perfectly. Conserving ammo is a pain in the ass, especially with guns like these. There are some aircraft, though, that come with cannons that have just a shit ton of shells. But with aircraft like this, where you've got 2 cannons, but barely any ammo between them, you know, it can be a little difficult to conserve them. I'm scanning the horizon, seeing if I can see any black dots out there. Oh, fuck, now he's speaking to me in Russian. Or whatever the hell that is, I don't know. I'm sorry, man, I have no idea what the fuck you're saying. Do you speak English? I'm sorry, I don't speak Russian. And I don't want to say that I don't speak Russian because then he'll come over and shoot me down. It's just the servers they're flooded. I'm on the European server, damn it. Actually, I don't even know if I'm on the European server. I have only the EU and US servers. But I don't remember having a ping like this on the EU server, so maybe the game derped me and put me on a Russian server. Now, I don't see any flak from our base over there, so that's an interesting one. I'm going to go ahead and travel off this direction. Because if he's going to try and loop around... He probably would have gone one of these ways. Why does it look like we're on a Minecraft world? Why is the whole thing square? Why is it not... it renders the very background, but it doesn't render in between. That's really odd. My render settings are as far up as they can go, but I guess I am up quite high, and the game just doesn't render that far? Oh well. Who knows? Who knows? Who knows? I don't know. This guy could be down at, like, bottom altitude. I gotta watch my fuel. See, it's a good thing I went with 30 minutes of fuel a few matches ago instead of my 20 minutes basic fuel, because when you get in situations like this, having that extra 10 minutes of fuel really goes a long way. I could drop my throttle and conserve more fuel, but, well, you know what it's like. So he looks like he's going to be circling their airfield, probably waiting for them to come back and land, maybe? Or is he in a dogfight? I can't tell. I think I'm up a little too high. I'm going to level out here. Watch that be my demise. And this other guy's at like 200,000 feet. He's in space. He's coming down from space. It's just a blazing rocket. And he fires off heat-seeking missiles. Well, this is big poof cloud here, so I didn't know if he'd be on the other side of this or not. Hello, I am here to take you away. Man, I don't think I've ever been out this far on this map. Holy mother of shit. Look at this. It's like a whole new world. But if we don't do things quickly here, yeah, the game's already destroying off the AI, so I'm gonna have to turn around and go ground attacking. Even if I don't like it, but I've gotta try because they'll start taking down our AI. Well, our AI will be taking down their AI, but if we let them go for too long, I'm pretty sure that their tank columns will bust through our defenses and end up winning that way. And I don't know if that's what this other guy on this enemy team is doing. Now, he has 0-0-0. If he goes 0-0-0-0-0-0 for the entire match, I'm not exactly sure what he's doing. Where the hell is he gone? Now, he's obviously not at their airfield, so he's not AFK on their airfield, but he could be AFK up in the air. Now, if he's purposefully trying to stay away, you can properly report him for the behavior, a passive behavior. But since I don't have solid proof that he's using that, although it is quite, you know, it's kind of obvious, I can't just go and report him right now for it. I have no idea where he is or why. Why he is. I have no idea why he is. He could be down low, for all we know. Maybe that's why we haven't seen him yet. Now, the biggest thing here is to not rip my wings on the way down. Now, my idea is if I start attacking their ground vehicles, maybe that'll draw him to me. And since my LA-7 buddy over there is close, maybe he'll be able to jump on the asshole and take him down. Well, he's going the other way, but whatever. All I gotta do is take down some of their tanks, and they'll be a lower thing than us. I think in this game, if you end the game with a tie, you both get a victory. I don't think there's a draw. There could be. But if there is a draw, as far as I know, that it's it counts as a victory for both of you, unlike World of Tanks. I should say unlike any of the three games that they've got going on over there. Because in that, if you get a tie or a draw or whatever, it counts as a defeat for both teams. Which can be ass. Because you get seriously hammered for defeats in terms of reward. And you do in this game, too. They added, you don't get hammered as hard, but they removed the fact that you... Because back in the day, it was based purely off of personal performance, and now it's based off of team performance. If you lose, even if you do spectacular, you can lose and get shit for reward compared to what you would have gotten on a victory. Which sucks, but at least it's not, like, super bad. Okay, now their AA, is this heavy AA? Because if it is, I'm going to have to take that down first. But I'm trying to get in to get one of their tanks. Now, I swear to fucking God, if I catch on fire, I will kick somebody's ass. Mother of fuck, it is heavy AA. Well, I didn't get all the AA, but at least it's not all shooting at me. No, pull out of that, please. The hell, where the fuck are their tanks? No, seriously, where the fuck are their tanks? What? Their tanks are going the other way! Son of a bitch! Okay, looping this thing back around. I'm really hoping... See, my main goal here isn't just to get some ground kills. It's mostly for me to try and get the attention of the asshole on the enemy team. Okay, now I'm going to try and loop around and get one of these tanks. Oh, fuck, there's still more AAA. Now, I have been shot down countless times by this AAA, so... I'm going to hope that they don't derp me here. Okay, those are all vehicles, not going to shoot them. See, I've only got 184 shells left. Okay, now that... Okay, so we got medium tanks turning that way. Oh god, there's still one of these assholes down here. I've got ground target loaded, but... Okay, I missed them. I'm going to have to go out for the second one. Oh shit, there's a plane behind me. So I did draw his attention. I didn't notice him until the last second. So I did draw his attention, and he was somewhere over here. So I'm going to start turning away now. LA-7's coming in for... I got lucky there, because I didn't notice him at first. He could have easily ripped me to shreds. Okay, now I'm going to keep this guy in a close quarters fight. That, I'm not going to be able to get up there in time. Okay, missed his lineup. I'm going to zoom this thing around as best as possible. That LA-7's coming in. This guy's got low chances. But he is still not... He's not a bad pilot. We got a good hit on each other there. He's wrecked my right wing. Now I got to keep this thing in airborne. He's also hit my engine a little bit. I've still got some ammunition left. Not sure who caught him on fire, but he's on fire in two different places. I guess I caught him on fire, because that burst I just fired off wasn't the killing blow. So, I could have been able to communicate with this guy a little better and tell him that I was trying to grab the guy's attention, but since we don't speak the same language, you know, that wasn't exactly the easiest thing to do. And I didn't manage to take down any tanks, but 5 kills, 10 ground kills? I'm not complaining about that. GG. GG to this LA-7 pilot. He might not have grabbed any kills, but he did manage to keep the enemies occupied very well. See the result of that. That was a very good, fun, enjoyable match. Nice. 21,000 RP and 152,000 Silver Lion gain. That is a good chunk towards the X-17. Very happy with that. That one is definitely being uploaded. Oh, I got my reward for Eagle's Eye. So the next one, using a fighter, players defeated, 12? I could do that. Shouldn't be too hard. Let's see, how much longer do I have? 1 hour and 48 minutes to do... Oh, yeah, but that mission lasted longer than 30 minutes, so it counted as two missions. That sucks. I wish it wouldn't do that. That fucking sucks. Gaijin, why did you put that in the game? So, two missions? Should be able to get that done in an hour and 48 minutes. Thanks for watching. I'll see you in the next video.